On June 9th, we knew two things. The first was that ticker UPST, which is trading for about $160 a share, had an upcoming share lockup expiry, and two, option premiums on that stock were through the roof, so we knew there'd be some opportunity with our option selling strategies. What we came up with resulted in a trade where the worst outcome was that we could make a couple $1,000s. Here's how we did it. Welcome to Hourglass Trader, where as time passes, we make money. So as we quickly mentioned in the intro, we knew UPST had a share lockup expiry coming up. Typically, when a company first begins trading, there's a period of time where big investors who got in pre-IPO are not allowed to sell their shares. This is to prevent a huge sell-off, as they would all try to sell their stock at the same time to try and lock in their gains. A share lockup prevents this. What this means is that big investors, normally institutions, aren't allowed to sell any shares post-IPO for a predetermined period of time. At the beginning of June, that predetermined period of time was about to expire for UPST, meaning large investors could all dump their shares at the same time. Now, a share lockup expiry doesn't always mean a stock will drop. For example, if an institution owned a huge number of shares at $22 per share, and the stock was trading at $25 a share headed into a lockup expiry, there probably wouldn't be a big sell-off because it's not worth it to unload such a large position to lock in a $3 gain per share. However, if an institution had a bunch of shares at $22 apiece and the stock was trading at $160 a share headed into the share lockup expiry, then there'd likely be a decent sell-off because they'd be locking in a monster gain, and that's exactly what we saw with UPST. So with that in mind, we knew that we wanted to play UPST down, but the question was how. If you're familiar with a covered call, you know it's a bullish strategy where you buy shares and sell a call, hoping that the stock runs up to the strike of the call that you sold. What we tried to do was basically the opposite. A covered put, which would be a bearish strategy, where we short stock, sell a put, and then hope that the stock drops to the price of the put that we sold. Here's what that would look like. And this is what the potential outcomes for that trade would look like using www.optionsprofitcalculator.com, which has a really useful tool to help you model out potential trades. So this trade accomplishes what we want because it makes us money if the stock goes down. But let's take a look back at the setup really quickly. There's one issue. With this play, we're shorting the shares, but the shares for UPST were listed as HTB, meaning hard to borrow. This occurs when a lot of people are trying to short the same stock. This is a problem because one, a broker may close out of the short position without notice, and two, brokers charge high borrowing fees on hard to borrow stocks, which would have cut into our profits. So how do we solve this? The answer is to open a position that is synthetically the exact same as shorting shares. We can do this by selling a call with little to no extrinsic value, which is exactly what we did by selling a 45 strike call, which is deep in the money. The 45 strike call had $111.25 of premium, which if you add those two numbers together, the 45 and the 111.25, that comes out to $156.25, almost exactly the price of the stock, indicating that there's almost zero extrinsic value on these calls that we sold. So why does this work the same as shorting shares? Let's say the stock drops $1 and you're shorting 100 shares. You'll make 100 bucks. If the stock drops $1 and you've sold 45 strike calls like we have, the price of the option will drop from $111.25 to $110.25, also resulting in a $100 gain. So synthetically, these are the exact same position with the added benefit that we don't have to worry about paying borrow fees or getting our position automatically closed out during the day by the broker. So that gives us this setup you see right here, which results in these potential outcomes. However, there's still a ton of risk if the stock shoots up, and this isn't quite the zero risk play we've teased for the video. So let's work on that part. What's the best way to hedge that risk? What will protect us if the stock ran up? The answer is buying a call. So we'll take this original position that we had right here and add a third leg where we purchase a call. And it's important to note here that we're purchasing the call at a 2-to-1 ratio to the put and call that we sold as the first two legs. That gives these potential outcomes. So by simply adding calls, we've gone from these potential outcomes where we had infinite potential losses on the upside to these potential outcomes where we now have infinite potential returns on the upside. And it wouldn't be a fully risk-free play if I didn't mention the tiny bit of red that we see at the bottom here. So to solve that, we'll do exactly the same thing we did to solve our upside risk and buy a couple of puts to hedge our downside risk. And finally, that gives us these potential outcomes, and the website we're using doesn't even know what color to shade the boxes because there isn't a scenario here where we lose money. All in all, this took about $16,000 of collateral and resulted in a trade where the worst case scenario was that we made $2,600, which is a baseline return of about 16.25%. Not too bad for a few minutes of work. So now you're probably wondering, why did this work and what's the catch? This works because we ran into a position where the extrinsic value on the deep in the money put we sold, the 280 strike put, far outweighed the price of the calls that we purchased to hedge the position. There was roughly a $15, $16, $17 difference between the two, which is what made our hedge turn our entire trade profitable. And it's important to note this is not typical. To illustrate this, let's take a look at Apple's option chain. If you look at the 148 strike, you'll see that extrinsic value on the puts is about 75 cents, while the premium on the calls at the 148 strike, the same strike, is about 71 to 72 cents. So those numbers match up, the extrinsic value on the puts and the premium on the calls at the same strike. This is what you'll typically find, and the fact that the shared lockup expiry was coming for UPST provided what's called a put skew, meaning that puts carry more premium at comparable strikes than calls do. That's what allowed us the opportunity to create this risk-free play. You might also be wondering if we had to sell the 280 strike on the puts and buy the 240 strike on the calls for it to work. We modeled out a ton of different possible trades and strikes, that this is the one that I felt gave us the best trade-off between minimum return and maximum return. At the end of the day, as long as the extrinsic value on the put we sold was at least $4 or $5 greater than the calls we bought to hedge, we were going to find ourselves in a risk-free trade. In this situation, the difference was roughly $17. And last but not least, there is one little catch. I'm sure you've heard there's no such thing as free money, but this is really, really close. But since the 45 strike call we sold was deep in the money and had zero extrinsic value, we were at risk of being assigned early. And during the first week we were holding this trade, that happened. But there's no need to panic. Getting assigned on the 45 strike call now means that we're just short 100 shares, which is the original position that we wanted in the first place. So we'll remember from that that the risk is that our broker could close this trade out early at any point and completely shift the return profile of the trade. To address that risk, we reached out to our broker, let them know our plan, and that we were able to buy back our short position, sell another 45 strike call, and then do the same thing again the next day. So there you have it, an example of how we can use option selling strategies to take advantage of special cases in the market and set ourselves up with virtually risk-free trades. If you're still with us, thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe to our channel and join our free Discord server if you haven't yet. The YouTube videos take a little bit of time to make, but we alert all of our trades and ideas as we come up with them in our Discord server, so that's the best way to make sure you don't miss a thing. Until next time, this has been the Hourglass Trader, where as time passes, we make money.